So, hey everybody, once again, let me close this. So, there we go, back to the game. Hey, we're back with another session of Fire in the Lake, and I'm Jeremy.
And I'm Nick.
And we're continuing our short campaign game. So, yeah, that's where we're at right now.
We were talking about the mistakes that we made last time.
Oh,
Is
that's
that
right.
correct?
So, you know, it's and no playthrough is ever Mario free of mistakes, really. And we only made a couple minor errors in the last playthrough, and a user on Board Game Geek was so kind as to watch the video and point out some of the errors. And one of them was that apparently when I'm playing Arvin in the U.S. If you're just tuning in, I'm playing the counterinsurgent factions, the Army of the Republic of Vietnam and the United States. And as Arvin, one of my victory goals is to build patronage, and I do that through a special activity, Govern. So I'll go look at Govern real quick. And the thing about it is, you can with Govern you can add aid or patronage, and I did a little bit of both. But when you add patronage, you actually transfer that from aid. And I didn't realize I was supposed to take it from aid. So I already lowered it before Nick and I were just talking earlier. I already lowered the aid down. It was at 12. I lowered it down to 10 because I'm pretty sure I just moved up my patronage by 2. So next time in the future, I'll remember doing that.
Yeah.
The other thing we did was apparently the My Lai event that gave the VC that wonderful base in Guerrilla in Saigon. Well, apparently you can't target cities with that event, so that was a little bit of a goof up. We probably just didn't read the card very well. But you know, that's one thing I'm not. I don't. You know, the other stuff we can kind of fix. This one would be too much of an effort to go back and figure it out. And I'm okay with just letting it hang out in Saigon because it's a little bit more of a challenge, and that's always great.
Yeah, and this is the way that you learn in
Exactly,
these
right? Like,
sorts
I
of
won't ever do
games.
that again. So I'll be like, wait a minute, that's a little too powerful. So that's cool. We messed that up. And then one other thing they told me is I mentioned the other cast we did that you can't airstrike in cities. Actually, you can airstrike in cities. I was sort of like, that'd be ridiculous. But then someone was like, no, in the rules, you actually can't airstrike in the city. So you still get to, if I airstrike, I still lose support, but I can actually target cities, which I thought that was an old carryover, but I guess I was totally wrong. And so
The
thanks to
lug buff.
the user who pointed that out.
It looks like it's the user lug bar on Board Game Geek.
Yes, thank you, Lugbar. He was kind enough. It could be he or she. They were kind enough to watch the video last time and point that out. So, you know, that's always great because, truthfully, we got 98% right. We just got a little bit wrong. So that's actually pretty good. And except for the Saigon thing, really nothing that really, I would say, breaks the game, and even that doesn't really break it. So
Yeah.
that sounds okay with me. I'm okay with just a couple errors. That's fine. So yeah, so that was about it. So let's take a look. Last time we left, we reset everything to go. So let's take a look at our sequence here. We've got, looks like the NVA and the US are eligible. The VC and the Arvin are ineligible. We've already gone through one coup round. That was the second card of the game,
Yeah.
which was interesting. And so we actually had, you can't see him here. It was Key or whatever his name is, that leader, Kai. I think we're supposed to actually drag that down. If you look down at the bottom of the map here in the Fire in the Lake map, there's an RVN leader spot. I probably should have dragged him over there because his thing is, I remember his ability or his penalty really, and it costs US or Arvin 4 resources to do pacification. So, you know, that's something easy to remember, but I think in the future when you do a coup card, you sort of drag it down here.
Okay.
Unless it's like a failed coup, because a failed coup keeps the leader that's named in power. You just The Arvin loses troops. They have desertion that occurs. So you can see here, there's two of the leaders. When you do the short game, the leader's already sort of determined, right? They're not in the game.
So wait, you're saying that this coup card here should be down there?
Right, like, so where we have Lansdale, like Lansdale's mug is on top of the coup card.
Yeah. Let's
I think you just dragged
get
that
that.
down. Oh, nice, you can actually move that. So yeah, let's just go ahead and move that down, and because he actually should go down there. And that way, it's just a way to remember what's going on.
I wondered why it was bigger than the rest of the cards.
Yeah, that sort of makes sense. And looking at it, I was like, oh, of course. And that makes sense now because you actually see discards. We have 6. Oh, that's nice. I didn't even notice that. We have 19 cards left in the deck with the 2 up there. So that's a pretty nice little way to reckon what's left. The short game is kind of short, but that actually is good enough to really get in the action and see what's going on.
And we've gotten pretty far, and we've been, what, that other video was about an hour?
It actually came out to be just
2 hours.
Under 2 hours. Mainly because we spent like 20 minutes in the beginning talking about the game, kind of, you know, and going over some of the rules. So that's why it took a little bit longer. And also, we were just talking more in general. And so this will probably go a little bit faster now that we've sort of already gone over some of the rules. I mean, I'll still talk out my thoughts, and I think we'll still have chat. But, you know, it should start picking up now. So yeah, we'll try to keep this one a little shorter today. I've got a little stopwatch now I'm looking at. So we'll try to keep this around an hour, because I think that 2 hours is great, but I think that may be too much for some people just to sit and watch. So we'll shoot for an hour today, because yeah, it's a short game, so this shouldn't take too many more sessions to get through.
That's good.
All right, so let's jump in. Let's see what card is up. Looks like it's Bombing Paws. All right, NBA.
Holiday.
Yeah, exactly, right? Ted Holiday Gesture. So the event says, set any two spaces to passive support, patronage plus two, no airstrike until coup, and that would stay in effect for the rest of the game. Or not the rest of the game, sorry, the rest of this round. It's a momentum piece.
Okay.
That's what that word, when it's a capability that stays in the game the entire time, but when it's actually just momentum, it just stays in effect until the next coup card, which still could be it for a while, because I think we've only played maybe a couple of cards after that coup card.
Mm-hmm. All right. So it looks like I am the first eligible faction on that card.
Yes. And as a reminder, Nick is playing the VC and the NVA. So he's got the Viet Cong and the... North Vietnam and the Viet Cong. So North and South. He's running both sides.
All right. So I am definitely going to go for first event.
Okay.
First faction event.
Okay.
With my guy there. And so on the card, it says that I can set any two spaces to passive support, patronage plus two. No airstrike until coup.
Yeah,
so that basically means I can demote two areas that have support to passive support?
Yes. Or, like, this could go either way, right? So if I had used it, I would pick places that were in opposition to passive support, but you can definitely pick active support and move it to passive support.
All right. So we're going to go with... Let's see. You have way too many guys up here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 to watch. We're going to set a quantum.
Okay.
To passive support.
Okay.
Which I don't think is really going to help me as much as I think it's going to. And we're going to set... Danang to pass... Or no, because I can't get to Danang. We'll set Kanto to passive support.
Okay.
Kanto, I can't really... Well, I guess I could try and do stuff with it. So...
There's Kanto.
Yeah, Kanto's down in the lower left.
I had to remember, I'm trying to get all the cities back. The geography.
Patronage plus two.
Yes.
So, let's see, where's patronage at? 20 right now, so it's go up to 22.
22.
Well, that'll work. It's angry. Why is it angry at me? It's okay. So that's basically just all I do, right? No airstrikes. You can't do any airstrikes, which is what I'm really...
Right, so for. Yeah. No more airstrikes for me until the next coup card. So that definitely hurts the U.S. ability to be offensive.
Uh-huh. All right. So, I mean, that's all you have to do, right?
That is, yeah, that's the text of the card. Yep, that's it.
All right,
so it's U.S. turn. So we've agreed somehow to this bombing pause. I don't know if that was questionable leadership. No, it's good. So let's see. I can't do that, but because you took the event, I get to now do an op plus special activity.
This is going to hurt.
So let's see. Last round, last session we had, I brought a bunch of guys into Quang Tri to sort of eliminate the presence there. So What would be some, what's, let's take a look at what the options I have for what I can do. I can do some training, I can patrol guys around, I can sweep and assault, and then I can't do airstrike, and my only other options are airlift to move a bunch of guys around or to advise. Advise may not be so bad. I think what I'm going to do this, we're going to, I have to do a train or patrol if I want to do that. Let's see. Okay, so the other thing I got to look at is who's coming up on the next card. It looks like Arvin is going to come up first, so that's going to be nice. That's going to be, since I'm playing both factions, that's going to give me a little bit of ability to do a 1-2 punch here. So I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to sweep.
Oh.
And I'm going to sweep in, let's pull out my little pieces here. I'm going to sweep in Saigon.
No!
Oh, yeah, it's got to happen. And, oh, we got this lone base hanging out here. That's okay. I'm going to sweep in Saigon. Oh, I really should assault, though, but that's, maybe I won't do that. And then I'm going to sweep in, can't really sweep in Pleiku. Actually, I could, couldn't I? I am going to sweep in Pleiku. What I'm going to do is I'm going to take, is that the only place I'm going to sweep? Those two places, and I'm going to sweep in Qian Gang. That'll be it. And so here's how this is going to work. In Qian Gang, I'm going to take my three troop guys that were in Qian Fong. They're going to cross the Mekong River.
Oh, no.
They're going to come into Qian Gang. So this is good in some ways because not only am I going to be able to try to sweep and reveal your guys, which I'm going to do right now in Qian Gang, but while I'm doing that, you can see that when I left Qian Fong, that took coin control out of there. And that's kind of, in some ways, if I was just playing the US, that would be good. Because in a way, if you notice, if we look at the victory track, Arvin is getting pretty close to getting above, you know, they're at 49 right now. So reducing coin control is sort of the key, right? I want to build support and not necessarily get coin control. But since I'm playing both factions, I sort of want to do both. But as a US player, you're always kind of aware that the more forces you bring in, that means you're putting more control, but that's not necessarily what you're trying to do, you know, right? You're trying to build support. So I'll do that in Qian Gang. And then what else can, oh yeah. So in Pleiku, I'm going to bring over two troops from Bin Din.
Pleiku? Ah, there we go.
And then, is that really all I need? Yeah, that's all I'm going to need, really. And actually, one from Khantoum. No, I'm going to leave that guy in Khantoum, actually. And with those two guys in Pleiku, that activates those two VC gorillas. And where else was I going to sweep? Oh, Saigon. And of course, I'll activate that one guy in Saigon. Because I did sweep, I can't do advise. I can't do airstrike, so I have airlift. I can start moving a bunch of guys around. So what I will do is I will airlift, and I will take some guys out of Quang Tri here. And what we're going to do is we're going to airlift them. Let's see, where should I go? Quang Tri is going to be one of the spaces, because I get to pick four spaces to move guys around in. So Quang Tri is one. And I'm going to move those guys. Oh, where is a good place to start? So yeah, we're going to basically go to Quang Nam. We're going to crop across the border. And then I'm going to put some guys into Bin Tui. That'll be the three spaces I transport. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take, let's put two guys in Quang Nam. And then let's group these guys together. Put 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'm going to do six. Take six of these guys out of Quang Tri, and they're going to go all the way down to Bin Tui. Let me make sure I can do that. Make sure that was possible. Any four spaces. Yeah, so I can pick any spaces. And I'll go ahead and separate these guys out so it's a little bit easier to see the mass amount of troops now building up in Bin Tui. And that's going to be that. So I'll end my faction play. We will hit this nice little end card play.
Okay.
Boop. There it goes. And now we draw a card.
We're in a strange rhythm where both of us get to go.
Yeah, exactly. Like, and that's what happens in this game. Like, initially we were doing the we both go on one turn, you know, and then you'll split it up, and then occasionally there'll be a time where someone will pass, and then it'll just be like three people on one side. So it definitely the order gets shaken up a lot. Like, it definitely starts off a little rhythmic, and then it gets back to being like totally, you know, in some different kind of pattern, just depending on what kind of cards come up. So like one thing I'm thinking about here is that you can see I've got International Forces. Arvin goes first on that. But if you look at the next card that's up, Henry Cabot Lodge, Arvin also goes first on that one. Mm-hmm. I'm losing, like, I won't be able really to act on that card, and that's a good card for me in the sense that I get to go first. You know, like, I'll get the first crack at anything if I pass and go for that card. So when you get a bunch of your own cards where you lead off, you start to realize, oh man, this is going to really impact my ability to do stuff later because I won't be the first in the card. You know, so sometimes you're like, ugh, you don't really want to see a bunch of your own first guys up, because even though they're good cards or they have good events on them, you're like, eh, I'd rather have those spaced out. So that's one thing you got to always think about. And that's really, and some people, like, you know, this is what I love about this game, the way it drives using these cards. And that's one level to it, I guess, is like, how does the faction order play out? You know, something you got to be thinking about, especially in a longer game when you have much more events out. But if you burn through a lot of your first or second events, then you know, oh man, I'm going to have a hard time getting the edge later on.
Yeah. Yeah, definitely.
So let's see. This card is International Forces. I can place... ooh, this is so not good. I could place 4 out of US pieces onto the map, which is not bad, but I already have a lot of guys, and I don't really need to... I don't think I really need more US guys.
But if you don't take this event, you're going to have to suffer for it.
I'll either have to suffer or just do a lot less. Which is always a pain. And the other thing is, I could take these guys, and because I'm playing both sides, I could take those 4 pieces out, and then during a coup round, I would essentially have 4 more available points to bring back, you know, like, because they're out of play. But if I put them into play and then take them off the board and put them onto the available spot, that's worth, you know, 4 points for the US. But I don't want to do that. Because I don't want to give the VC the ability to do a bunch of stuff, because they're pretty powerful, and I need to take care of the VC. So I think what we're going to do is just op only, no special activity. And it's going to be assault.
Okay.
So, because even though they're Arvin and they're not very good at fighting, we've got to do something. They actually can be pretty good in the cities, because they can use police, but otherwise they're not so great at fighting. So the places... So let's take a look at what assault says. Let's read this, because they are a little different.
So in each space, remove 1 active enemy piece, troops, then guerrillas, bases last, tunnel on 4-6. Per 2 Arvin troops in jungle or lowland, 3 Arvin troops in the highland, and any 2 Arvin cubes in city or line of communication.
Right.
Plus 6 aid per base removed. Ah, that's interesting.
Yeah, it's like, I think they have that in a distant plane where if you remove a Taliban base, you also get aid boost. So I think they kind of brought that over here. But so you can see that, like, okay, so the places I'm going to assault, and the thing is, this costs me 3 resources, and we still have a bunch of cards to go, and I only have 21 resources left as Arvin. So I got to be a little careful here. So I need to take care of the biggest threats first. The biggest threat to me is Saigon. And the next biggest threat... oh, but I'd only be able to get rid of 1 guy. Oh. Is that going to be worth spending 3 resources?
We have a visitor by the name of SK.
Oh, hey, yeah. Hey, SK. For sure. So I think what I'm going to do is... let me let know where we are.
Oh, yeah.
Just so he knows why we're not talking. Sometimes they're like, why aren't you talking more? But they probably assume we're using Ventrilo or something. So here's the deal. I'm only going to do this in Saigon. I could assault and play coup, but because it's Highlands, I mean, I'd only get to kill 1 guy because I only have 4 cubes there, right? And there's nowhere else I actually have enemy to target. Oh, I could do on Loke, though. But that'd only get rid of 2 guys. And I don't know if that's really that worth it to me. what can you do? Let's take a look. If you attack as NVA, I think you have the same thing. It's remove one enemy per two troops. Yeah. So it's the same thing. You do a 2-for-1. Yeah, I'm just going to pay for Saigon. I'm running kind of low on cash. I get a little worried about this, and I need to be pacifying, and that costs a lot of money. So we'll do that in Saigon. I'll take 3 off, down to 18. So I have enough to just take out that gorilla and the base. So I'm going to return him there, and he's going to go back. You're going to go back.
I'll miss you.
And then 6 more aid, because people are happy I took care of that. Even though they're seething in Saigon, the opposition, not so happy. But U.S. is happy.
That's my foothold in Saigon.
It is really tough for the VC to get large footholds in the cities. It can be really difficult. It's kind of like, I don't know if you haven't played Andean Abyss, but it's like that way with the cartels. If the cartels start really infesting the cities, they can be gotten rid of, but you know they can also make a lot of money and get a lot of bases in cities. So
once the semester begins and I can actually purchase a table, mm-hmm. I'm supposed to have a GMT game group, I think, starting here.
So nice.
Hopefully you're going to have 3 or 4 players.
Nice. All right, well, that's that. I will do that, and it's your turn.
All right. So, international forces. Let's see. So you didn't go for the event.
No, but I did a thing that would keep you from going for the event as well.
Yeah, you did.
Because that's a powerful one, and if you got 6, that could really hurt me.
So I guess my only option is to take the limited op, right?
Yeah, totally.
Alright. Or, I could pass so that my 2 factions can go and your 1 faction is out of balance. Ooh, this is tricky. For limited op, this is the VC. I could attack? No. Tear? I could. I think I'm going to pass.
Okay. Oh, I see what you're going to do here. Okay, nice. So you can, you pass?
Yeah.
All right, cool.
So we do end card play, right?
So yeah, what you normally saw move your guy, you move him down here and you're like, I pass. And you get 1 resource for passing.
Ah, excellent.
Yeah, you build up, get a little extra in the coffers.
That 22 spot has a lot going on.
I know. It's highly active here.
Alright. So, end card play. I'll click that. End faction play, right?
End faction play. That gets rid of all the pawns and movement trails or whatever.
Alright.
And then...
And draw a card.
Draw a card.
Henry Cabot Lodge. Move up to 3 Arvin pieces, patronage +2 for each.
Mm-hmm. And Arvin stays ineligible.
Oh! Alright. But, and I get to activate that card first, huh?
Yes, because I am ineligible. So, yeah, it looks like... Right, because I just went. So yeah, you get to go. NVA and then VC gets to go because the U.S. is last on this card.
Mm-hmm. All right, first faction, we're going to do the event.
Okay.
Move up to 3 Arvin pieces, patronage +2 for each. Arvin ineligible through the next card. So, Arvin are the yellow, right?
Yellow and that orange color.
Yellow and orange.
And you can choose anywhere from 0 to 3 pieces to remove.
Does it have to be from one province?
No, it can be from anywhere. I think the way the card is worded, usually they're all about direct wording. So 3 pieces, anywhere you can move up to. So like I said, 0 to 3, yeah. And then for each one you take off, we bump patronage up 2.
So I'm going to return 2 available forces, right?
Yes. They don't have they do have an out of play, but it's really just about the Vietnamization. I don't think they lose pieces to out of play otherwise.
Yeah. So we're taking 1 out of Compton.
Okay.
Up
here.
And we're going to take 2 out of Anlok.
Oh, yeah.
That should... Yeah, there we go. And then... So that's pretty much the end of that turn. Oh, wait. I get to add, Patronage goes up by 6.
Yes.
So 28.
Woohoo!
Oh, man.
So, yeah, again, because we were playing a two-player game, I have to we have to win with both factions. You know, like, normally this would put them in a winning position. The VC can take away their patronage, I think, through, what is it, Subvert? I think that's the way they eliminate patronage. I don't know if the NVA can get rid of patronage. I don't think so. So, yeah, I think only the VC and VC in the U.S. can siphon off patronage. I'm not totally positive about that, but it looks like it.
Okay. So, I'm left with a pickle here, because if I pass, Arvin will... You would have to pass as well.
If you this pass... This is complicated. If you pass, then I... Arvin's going to stay ineligible, but if you pass as the VC, then that means the U.S. can come up and act on this card.
Yeah. +20. My goodness. So my guys are basically going to... Oh, this is going to be... All right, we're going to do it. We're going to go for faction op here.
Okay, yeah. You got so much money. The VC can really have a lot of fun.
Yeah. I think I need to figure out what I'm doing here. Wish I could move those guys. Augment or recover friendly forces. Any province or cities without support, one resource per space. So I could add, if I did a rally, I could put all of my guys back in Saigon, couldn't I?
Let's see, you can rally in Saigon because it's got opposition, and you get, what is it, you can only put one guerrilla there because you don't have a base. If you had a base, then you could add the population, which is why that base is deadly in Saigon, because it's like, you know, recruitment central for the VC.
Yeah.
But you can put another gorilla back in Saigon, which is always annoying.
Yeah. So, all right. Place one per two with a VC base, or place two with a VC base. So I can only put one in there. So... If I could march people around, I could attack. Activate all of VC, roll a die, equal to physical damage, two bases. Activate all VC, roll a die, equal to or less than the number of VC gorillas, removes two enemies. Ooh, that's tricky.
Mm-hmm. See, like, if you did that in Qianyang or whatever down in the south, I mean, they're already active, right? That wouldn't even hurt you, but you'd have basically a 50-50 chance of killing guys.
Thinking about it, because it would get rid of your guys, but... You know what? Since they're already active, I'll do that down there. My faction op, I guess.
Okay.
So, let's see. We're going to roll the blue die. I have to get a 3 or better.
Ha ha! Curses!
So, 2 enemy, right?
Yep, 2 cubes. It's, I think, yeah. And this one, unlike in a distant plane, I think the distant plane, the Afghan government, like, kind of shields coalition troops. And in here, that's just not the case. Like, if the U.S. is hanging out, they definitely get taken out.
Alright, and then special... Let's see. I can do that, right? May add special activity.
Oh, yeah. Since you took the event, the next guy can always do full ops special ability.
Okay. Take over Arvin unit. Ooh. That would be interesting. Rally, march, or tear. Oh, dang. I should have looked first.
Well, if you want to take it back, you can. If you want to bring back my two troops.
No. So I can ambush.
Yes, you can. In fact, that would it gives you a free attack, but you have to have an underground guy, I think, so right?
Spaces where a VC gorilla who's marched or about to attack is underground.
Right.
So I can't do that. Looks like the only thing I can do here is tax.
Yes, you could tax. With an attack, yeah. The attack is sort of a very limiting one because you pretty much are all out doing something.
Yeah.
But, same time, two guys, that's 6-8 right there. You know, like, that's definitely good. Yeah. And there's definitely a strategy of the VC to just attrition away U.S. troops and just, you know, deny aid and deny troops, you know.
So, can I do that in Kim Gang?
Let me see. I don't think you have to flip them. Let's see. Up to 4 space. You have to have an underground. So, yeah, you have to activate a VC gorilla to tax. You could do it in Quang Duc or Tainin.
Yeah, let's go for Tainin.
All right.
Up to 4 spaces. Each space. So, what's the wording on this card? It says, each space, activate that VC gorilla, shift one level toward active support, and add VC resources equal to econ or twice the population.
Right.
So that would make me, that would add 4 for each one that I uncover, or is it?
Oh, it's just in each space. In each space, you activate, because you can only target up to 4 spaces. In each individual space, you activate one gorilla, you shift it one level to active support, and then you add those resources.
Ah, okay.
So you can't, like, do 4 gorillas and Tain In and get, like, you know, totally burden it, but yeah.
Alright, so we'll add 2 VC resources equal to econ or twice the population. So the one in Tain In, that would mean that I get 4 resources?
Yeah.
Alright, so we'll go up there, and then in Quang Duck, I don't know if it's really worth it. Eh, why not? Activate him, and I'll gain 2. 29. And then in Quang Duck, it is that.
Yes.
All right. So I think that's it for me.
Okay.
So end card play?
End card play, and then draw card, yeah.
End faction play. Draw card.
All right, so looks like I got U.S. and Arvin up, so we're back to...
Arvin shouldn't be up.
Arvin is... Oh, no, Arvin isn't up. It didn't know that we're doing that, right? So yeah. It stays ineligible. That's right. There you go. You got it. So it's just U.S. Just the lone U.S.
I saw you try to squeak that in there.
Got to get the edge. Well, let's see. So I got amphibious landing here. What does this do? U.S. or Arvin relocates any of his troops among coastal spaces, then free sweeps and assaults in one coastal space. Thing is, I've been doing a good job taking care of the coast. Although, Ken Gang definitely is annoying, but because you just killed my guys there. Need some retribution. That's actually pretty powerful in a lot of ways, but it's not. I can't really use it because the cities are pretty free of guys and the coast is pretty free of guys. So that's not a great event for the U.S. right now, but let's see what the other... And there's no other person to take it, so I don't really need to worry about you taking it.
Yeah.
Although you can see here the VC, that's a great event for the VC.
Yeah.
But at the same time, it's hard for them to get because they're the third person on the card. So I will definitely just do ops. Let's do some op and special activity.
This was my conundrum. Because if I had allowed you to go, mm-hmm. and you did a special activity or whatever,
I would
definitely have been able to get this card.
Yes.
But the operation seemed like it would be better for me. I don't know.
Yeah, because there's a lot of times you want to take the events. That happens in this game a lot. A lot of times you'll see events, you're like, this is great, you know, but at the same time, it's like if you don't keep the operations up, you know, then you're not going to have people on the ground, you know, you're not going to be able to do things. And the events are powerful, but... You really got to use them in conjunction with your larger strategy, right? Like what you're trying to accomplish. So for me, I'm the U.S. I'm going to take that event, or I'm going to do this op and special, and unfortunately, I'm just really going to probably assault. That's kind of the name of the game here. Because it's actually...
Always yelling at my guys.
Always. Got to always be closing, right? Always be launching attacks. I will assault in Pleiku. I will assault in Bintui. And... probably should assault. Oh, here's what I'm gonna do. Okay, so I'm gonna do those assaults, and I'm also gonna assault in Qian Gang. But what I'm gonna do first is, because I can do a special activity, I'm gonna use my transport special activity. And what I'm gonna do is, I'm actually gonna take guys out of Bintui, because I was gonna actually try to go into Quang Dog some of those guys. What I'm gonna do is, I'm gonna take guys out of Saigon, and I'm gonna move. Let me look at my attack again real quick. So if I assault in the jungle, or like highlands, is that is? Qian Gang is lowlands. So if I assault, zoom in here so I actually can read it. Each space, remove one active enemy piece for each US troop cube, two for one in a US base, only one for two in highland. Without a US base, one of the spaces, okay. So it doesn't say anything about lowlands. I guess I get 1-1 on lowlands. Oh, you know what we forgot, though? I forgot about this. When you attack in... Whenever insurgent faction attacks the U.S., it suffers attrition. So for every person you kill, you lose a guy.
Really?
Yes. I totally forgot about that. We'll let that slide here, because I forgot about it, and that would actually probably change your thinking. So we'll definitely just keep that way, because I'm gonna have to shift guys around, so I'll probably still get the same effect, but I'm going to be... spreading myself a little thin, which is okay. So what I'm gonna do is, I'm gonna transport guys out of Saigon, and I'm gonna take two guys out of Saigon. So I'm gonna do my special activity first, essentially, right? I'm gonna transport or airlift these guys into Qian Gang from Saigon, and then I'm gonna do my assaults. So I'm gonna get rid of the three guys in Qian Gang, because I have three troops there. So we're gonna flip those guys over and return them. I will assault in Bintui. This gets rid of a base, so that goes away.
This is making me cry.
And then I will assault in Pleiku, and what I'm going to do is, I get, because I have a base there, I get a 1-for-1 because it's the highlands. Mm-hmm. Or do I get, do I get 2-for-1, or is that 1-for-1 with highlands? Let's see. 2-for-1 if base, or only 1 for every 2 of highland without without a US base. 2-for-1 in a base. So I read that as saying that I can probably... Let me look this up just to be really safe. I know that this is always confusing to me too. I was like, is this okay in Highlands? Do I get the 2-for-1 in Highlands if I have the base?
This is for assault?
This is for assault. So let's see.
Yeah, that is a huge amount of text.
If U.S. assault, count U.S. troops. Remove 2 enemies per U.S. troops cube if the space has a U.S. base, or only 1 enemy for every 2 U.S. troops if it's highland with no U.S. base. Otherwise, 1 enemy piece for each U.S. troop. So it looks like I get 2-for-1.
Okay.
So I will get rid of those. I'm going to get rid of everything here. So I get rid of both those gorillas and the base in Pleiku.
No!
I'm going to return those to available. And get rid of that guy. Return to available. And so those are my three assaults, and I did my airlift, so that is it. Yes, so I'm going to do in faction play. I guess now I can do in card play. And the Arvin now gets to pop back into eligibility. And we're gonna draw a card.
Economic aid.
Yeah, it looks like NVA is up.
Ooh, Moscow's gonna get improve the trail 1 box, then either improve it 1 more box or add 10 NVA things. So trail. Where is the trail at?
It is over here on the left side of the map, just below your red force box for the NVA. Yeah. So here's the deal. If you move it all the way to four, then that means you get to march for free all through in and out of Laos and Cambodia. And essentially, the rules say that you get to free march as many spaces as you want in Laos and Cambodia.
Yeah.
And pop out. So, like, you can take guys all the way from central Laos and in one move pop them down to the Parrot's Peak and then into Kien Phong or something. So yeah. It gives you high logistic capability, essentially.
All right. And I'm trying to remember. What is my... So the Viet Cong opposed plus bases need to be at 36 in order for me to win, right?
Yes, you want to build opposition.
Where does the NVA plus bases need to be? Oh, way up there. Oh, my God.
Yeah, they're looking for a lot more... Their thing is all just getting NVA control plus bases. So usually, I mean, you've got most of your bases on the board. You only have two more to put out there. The big thing is just building up a lot of troops and then surging to take control of areas.
Yeah. All right. So I think I'm going to go with the... because Red doesn't really need resources right now. So we're definitely going to go for... improving the trail two spaces.
Okay.
So we'll move the trail up to four. And we're going to, we have to put red into the event. But I think you go next, don't you?
Yeah, Arvin is up next.
All right,
so what is Arvin? Herman needs to kind of got a lot of control. It's spread, but it's kind of spread thin. And I don't want to spend a ton of resources. And what's the next card?
Do I want land cell?
Yeah, but I don't want the VC necessarily to go. So I think what we're gonna do is we'll do something. Let's see, what can Arvin do? I could train, I could patrol. Probably what I'll do is I'll end up training. Well, do I want a sweeper assault? Is there anywhere I need a sweeper assault? Guess I could do that in Onloke. I could try to just get Kien Phong. That might not be a half bad idea either.
Oh, Lamson.
Yeah, so I think what I'm going to do is... Oh, God. I'm just running out of money. I'm like, do I really want to start... bring the noise and the ruckus, as they say in the song? Let's see. If I train, I could govern, which is nice. That's not Saigon and not selected for training, which is probably maybe what I'll do. Yeah, maybe that's what I'll do. So I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to train and govern. And I'm going to train in Quang Tri because now the U.S. came in and sort of saved my bacon there. I need to re-put guys in there because that's my only base on the board. Arvin only hits like one base until you do Vietnamization. And so that's like your one base you get to have. And you can train, I think, at U.S. bases or cities, but this is like my one outpost. And what I'm going to do is just only train there because I don't want to spend a ton of money. So we're going to do that one space. I'm going to go down three. So here's the other thing. You notice I just hit the econ marker there at the top. That means the U.S. can't spend any more money of the Arvins. Like, can't spend any more on Arvin stuff.
Okay.
Because that's like the floor, you know, that's sort of the lowest that the U.S. can go to. And the Arvin can spend that money, but the U.S. now is sort of hampered. I'm going to bring in six troops up there. Well, wait, do I need police? Do I get to add police too? Let's see, train. Place one to two rangers or up to six Arvin cubes. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put in five troops. Oh, I only have two troops and police. Well, that's kind of lame. Okay, so here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to put those two troops that are there, and I'm going to take those up there, right? So I'm going to take those two. I'm going to put them up here all the way in Quang Tri. I'm going to put two police in there as well, because I sort of want to have some police presence. Because that's what I need to pacify or to be able to do that if I want to. And then the thing is, I want more troops in there, but I'm out of available forces. So I can take guys off the board and then move them up there if I want. So I think I'm going to take two guys out of Kanto, and essentially I'm going to return them to available forces.
Okay.
So it's getting even weaker there. And then I'm going to take those two, and essentially it's let you just reposition guys, but you have to take them off the board somewhere, and you can only do it if you have no guys available of that type.
Well, you've managed to take over most of the stuff down there.
Yeah, so I'm thinking that this is a little bit safer for me to take a little guys out of here and move them up to Quang Tri. And
he's not happy with this.
This line, man, this this will not stand. So we'll take Quang Tri, and then I'm gonna govern. And let's see. So because I messed up govern last time. Let's take a look at this and get it a little closer. So obviously you can only do it if you train or patrol. And I get to do one or two coin-controlled spaces that have support and are not Saigon or selected for training. So the places where I have coin control where there's support and there is no... Ooh, there's not that too many places with support. I'm looking.
Yeah, I've been trying to destabilize your support structures.
Yeah, and the problem is that I've... Okay, so what I'm going to do is that we're going to govern in Da Nang. I have people there, but no support, or I have some support. And we'll go ahead and govern in Kwinon. And this is going to go straight towards patronage. So what we're going to do is we're going to, because I have more cubes than you have cubes there, I'm going to transfer the population value from aid to patronage and shift it towards neutral. So Cameron is going to go towards neutral. I get one more patronage, but I lose one aid. And then I'm going to do the same thing in Da Nang. I'm going to adjust it to there. I lose an aid and gain a patronage.
Oh, man.
So, yeah, that's building up the old Saigon networks. Good old boys.
Coin plus patronage is so far up there. Oh my god.
Yeah, it's surging. We're surged.
I need to start whittling that down as fast as possible. Right.
The NDA can build up pretty quickly, so that generally is not a huge deal, but yeah, if I start building a lot of patronage, that gets a lot harder to start taking down. Okay, so that's it. That's all I want to do on the economic card. So I'm going to end faction play. I'm going to end card play. And we're going to draw a card.
Alright. Ooh. Perfect Lao. NVA removes six of its pieces. Total from North Vietnam and Laos. Well, that's no fun.
Yeah, that's no fun.
With our U.S. and redeploy them to Vietnam. Wow. Okay, so, blue and green.
So what's up? Yep. So does this mean, I guess I'm up, huh?
Mm-hmm.
All right, so Lamson, sorry, I thought you were up. I was like, oh yeah, blah, blah, blah. All right, so U.S. can't spend Arvin money, which means it can't pacify. So I think it's time... We're going to sweep.
Okay.
And because... Let's see what this event is. Again, now I need to pay attention to this event. Yeah, I don't really want the VC taking that because you might want to give... I don't know. Does the NVA need resources? No, they have so many.
Yeah.
Yeah. But I don't want you doing fun things, so I'm just going to do... Because I can't airstrike, and I don't really need to airlift or... advise. I could advise, but I guess it costs free. I could advise somewhere, but once again, Arvin's not really doing a whole lot. Yeah, there's nothing really for Arvin to really make moves on. So I think what I'm going to do instead is I'm just going to do just the op only, no special activity. And I'm going to sweep. We're going to sweep in one place. And that's going to be Quang Duc. And I'm going to... I'm going to take, let's see, 1, 2, 3, four, five, and
I'm outnumbered.
I'll take one guy from Kanhoa, because he's next door to Kwong Duck as well. And because it's jungle, you have to have twice as many guys as you're looking for, you know, because it's harder to find them in the jungle.
Yeah.
So I'm going to sweep there, so that's why I brought in six, so I could get these three gorillas activated.
Oh, man.
And, yes, so we'll do that, and I will hand it off to you.
So I can only do a limited op, or I can pass.
A limited op or pass.
So who's this? The BC?
Mm-hmm.
Rally, march, attack, tear. And I can attack. I could run away.
You can run away. I think, based on the rally, you... Let me tell you a rally quick. If... Without support, and... You could rally in Kwong Duck, and then put all those guys underground. Like, they could all just go back underground again.
Yeah, that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to do limited op, and we're going to rally... in Kwong Duck, and we're going to make them all not active. Now, does that, it's one resource per space?
Yeah, just one resource per space.
27.
Yeah. So this is kind of rough when the VC have so many resources, they just can start really bankrolling crazy operations, you know, and you don't need to tax as much. You just sort of, you can do lots of different things, and it's just harder to play whack-a-mole with them. And it's always annoying the jungle because you got to bring so many guys in just to displace a force.
Stupid coin control.
Stupid coin. Stupid jungle.
I'll get you. Alright, so, and card play. Right? Yeah.
Yep.
And a faction play. Draw a card. Hello, Fernando. By the way.
Oh, Fernando's in the room? I got this a little minimized to have more space. Nice.
We are broad. Do you know Fernando?
That sounds familiar. I don't know these people personally or anything.
Okay.
But it sounds like maybe someone that maybe was a playtester, but maybe just someone I see on BoardGameGeek. You know, Fernando's also not that uncommon of a name, I guess, for some people, so. Hello, Fernando.
Alright, so...
I'm going to get a drink of water. Keep going. I can hear you. I'm just going to get some water.
Oh, okay. So, NVA removes six of its pieces total from North Vietnam and Laos. If no coin control cubes in Laos, improve the trail two boxes. Twilight Struggle.
Oh, what about Twilight Struggle? No.
Oh, there's somebody in the Twitch chat saying that they've only ever played Twilight Struggle, which seems pretty simple compared to this. They said Twilight Struggle is GMT's baby.
Oh, yeah, that's the moneymaker.
Let's see. God, this Pathet Lao, I imagine you're probably going to end up getting this event.
Well, this is kind of a weird one. Yeah, I mean... Oh, you mean this. Let's see. Well, let's see. I mean... Oh, Arvin's in there. What do we do here? I could remove six of its... Ooh. Six pieces from North Vietnam and Laos. Although, technically, you only... I guess you do have lots of pieces in Laos. You have lots of bases. I would probably like to take your bases.
Yeah. But if I do that and do what the red one, can I do trail security?
What do you mean trail? I'm sorry. What do you mean?
The bottom part of that event.
Oh, let's see. Oh yeah, you could take any part. Yeah.
But you, so I'm trying to remember what the rule is here. If I do the event, you can't also do the event, right?
Yeah. So like if you on the sequence of play at the bottom. If you take event, then the second faction can do op and special activity, but it can't do the event.
Yeah.
Or if you just don't want the event to happen at all, you can just do an operation only with no special activity, and then the second person going can only do a limited op and can't take the event either.
I think that's what I'm going to do. The no special activity?
Sometimes that's like the most effective way to just keep people out of the event, but also keep them from running rampant, you know, because they can only do a limited op.
So where's the NBA? What am I going to do here? I've got operation. That's right, right? Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see. I could rally. +2 to improve trail. Oh. My guys can move all over the place.
Yeah, I mean, you've got total movement, and the way you build up forces here is you can rally to get your guerrillas on, and then use infiltrate to start replacing them with troops, or just putting a bunch of troops in, or taking over VC guys. That's the two ways you start getting a lot of forces on the board.
So, with the trail at this, march costs 0 resources. Can I march them literally anywhere on the board? Or is it only one space still?
No, because they have the ability to keep marching if it's in Laos and Cambodia. So normally it would cost you 1 extra per space. Like if you were marching from central Laos into southern Laos, that would cost 1. If you wanted to march again in northeast Cambodia, that would cost another 1. But since you're at trail level 4, it's all free. Like in and out of Laos and Cambodia is free. So you can be like, guys all the way from North Vietnam could jump into Laos, go all the way down to the fish hook, and then pop out to Tay Ninh for 0. I mean, it gives you the ability to really quickly move guys.
All right, we're going to do some tricky stuff here.
You could also conversely take guys out of On Lok and then move them all somewhere else. You know, like you have a bunch of troops up there. You know, they could just pop into the fish hook and then go anywhere, you know, for free.
So we're going to go from central Laos, those two guys.
Okay.
Into Pleiku.
Okay.
This third guy is going to go into Pleiku.
All right.
These guys up here on the line of communication, they can move as well, right?
Yes, but that will cost you 1 unless you move to another line of communication.
Yeah, no, they're moving also to Pleiku.
Here it comes.
And it seems, is the game hanging?
Oh, is it?
I think so. I think this happened last time. We just waited. Or it happened to me last time.
Oh, it did?
There it goes.
Oh, there it goes. Yeah, maybe it's just thinking. All right, well, I see the move to Pleiku.
These two guys in Fishhook, guess where they're going?
Uh-oh.
So.
Man, Pleiku's heating up.
Moving that down. I don't know, I may be putting all of my ducks in one pond. Well, I made up a new saying.
I don't have an airstrike capability, so I mean you can pretty freely move your troops around and it's gonna be tougher for me to get into fights with them. Or just wipe them off the board.
Parrot speak. What can I do in parrot speak? I can do something fun. Move them to Kien Phong. There we go.
Oh, yeah. And so you could now, I think, if you just moved, you could infiltrate and take over a BC guy there.
But I don't... Can I do... no special activity.
Oh, right. You only... I'm sorry, yeah. Only opsin, that's right.
Haha, I knew a rule.
Good job. Yeah. I'm so quick. I'm like, you could take over the BC. Why don't you just do whatever you like to do with the rules?
Alright. So, I guess that's it for me in terms of what I can do.
Alright. Up to the old Arvin. What is Arvin? Well, Arvin has to do a limited op. And still not having a lot of money. This is kind of where... I don't really want to... Let's see. Yeah, this is where Arvin's going to pass. Although, maybe. Because I just really can't start... I really am trying to save some of this money for pacification. Because as the U.S. player, I'm thinking, I need pacification. And I need money. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to pass, actually, instead of doing that. I'm going to pass. I get 3 resources for doing that. And... Cool. So that's that. So in faction, in card play, yeah, it even knows when it's in past. Move it up. Oh, that's great. And then we will draw a card.
Medivac. Ooh, another momentum card. No!
Oh, wow, yeah. This commitment, all troop casualties are available, and then executing faction remains eligible until coup, no airlift. Oh, wow. So, interesting. Looks like NVA is up on... Or, I'm sorry, VC is up on Sonte.
Sonte, what can I do here? 2 troop casualties, 2... I know. Any 2 casualties out of play. U.S. ineligible through the next card. Well, damn.
Yeah.
That's a intense thing.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, that lets you get rid of 2 guys right away. Because normally the thing about casualties is that you have to, you lose 1 of every 3. Like when we do the coup round, I take out 1 of every 3 guys there and put them out of play. And that's the way you slowly reduce the amount of troops that the U.S. actually has available. But this card just lets you automatically take 2 and pop them right out.
Yeah, I am definitely going to go for the faction, or for the event there.
Okay.
So, any 2 casualties out of play. And U.S., are you immediately moved to inactive? Or to,
Yes, I'm through the next card. So this card and the next card.
So casualties.
Boom. I moved over.
Oop, I did the wrong thing here. There we go.
Oh, yeah, there you go.
And then you can do all sorts of crazy stuff, but you don't have much money. So
but I don't have a lot of money. Yeah, exactly. So it's like, what am I going to do? So this is where you start like, well, I can see that obviously, like, damn, you're just getting a lot of guys. I guess what I'm going to start doing is doing what I can. I'm actually going to do an op and special activity. Let me see what I can do here, actually. I'm going to assault.
You can do quite a bit.
I can do quite a bit. I could start doing some things. Let me see. So first I'm going to assault. Let me look at raid. I think I'm going to do an assault and raid. Because I've only done raid once. Let's take a look at raid. I can do it because I'm doing an assault. I can do any 1 or 2 spaces. And in each space, move in any adjacent rangers if desired. Then if desired, activate an underground ranger there to remove 2 enemy pieces. That's not bad. Oh, although transport lets me flip all rangers underground, which is kind of nice, because I think I have ranger, but they're all in the cities doing rangery things. Yeah, they're not anywhere I really need them to be. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to assault and transport. That's what I'm going to do. And what we're going to do is we're going to do transport first. And is there anybody I want to move? Oh, I don't want to leave Saigon. Totally open.
So you can decide the order if you want to do special activity then operation?
Yeah, you can decide. Okay. You can also do it in the middle. Like, you can do something and then in the middle do a special op. Because sometimes you might run out of money or something and then you want to get money back. I don't know. There's ways that you can mess with it. And I think that's been sort of a standard in all the coin games. This one says you can do it in the middle of stuff. And I think that might be new, but you've always had the ability, I think, to choose to do... I know you've always had the ability to choose to do the special op first, then the operation, because sometimes you got to move guys to do it.
This is my left-right thinking.
Oh, yeah, doing operations in special. For the counterinsurgents, it usually works better the other way, because you want to transport guys first and then attack. or do those kind of things. You guys move more guys around. Sometimes it's helpful for like the NBA if you're going to do like infiltrate or something and then do an attack. Things like that. But or can you do infiltrate and attack? I say that and then I'm like, is that really? No. So you can you can infiltrate and then rally or something, right? Like you could, you know, I don't know, there's little combos you can do that way. For the, you know, BC, you could definitely do attacks and then whatever. Or you could ambush and then move away. You know, like you can, that's always not bad. You could ambush on an LOC and then move out or something, right? So yeah, there's ways you could combine them to do that and get some sort of better strategic effect or whatever you're trying to do. I'm going to do transport and assault. So I'm gonna, first I'm going to transport, and I can move up to 6 Arvan troops or rangers from one space to LOCs or cities if I want. And then, you know, so I can use LOCs or I can go adjacent. And really just want to... I'm going to take 2 guys out of Saigon, and we're going to come in Onlok.
Onlok?
Yeah.
Oh, man.
And I'm also going to use this opportunity to flip this one ranger underground who's in Bintui. And...
Can he? I didn't even notice he was there. He's that good.
He's that good. Troops are ranged from Wiz. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to also move that ranger from Bintui, and he's going to pop into Kwangduk because I can move him. So that'll be my transport. Do I want to move my other guys anywhere else? Yeah, that's fine. That'll be my transport, and then I'm going to assault and onlook. So that's 3 resources. And how many guys do I have here? I think I have, let's see, 6, and I get to count police and cities, so that's 8. So my assault will remove 4 NBA troops.
No.
All right. That's what I'll do there. I'm going to end faction. We're going to end card play, but we're going to keep the U.S. ineligible. So he's going to pop over here, but we're actually going to move him back to ineligible.
Okay.
And then we're going to draw a card.
Good old NBA.
And how about, so like, we've almost been coming up on an hour, so you want to go through this card and then call it a good session for today?
Yeah, that'd be great.
Okay, cool.
Uh-oh. Gotta wait for it to catch up with me.
Oh, did you move it and then move it out?
Yeah. There you go. So what is this card? Let's see. Medvac. So you can't really do anything with this card.
Nope. I'm totally out.
But if I take the event, executing faction remains eligible until coup, no airlift.
Yeah, so you can actually take this and then stay eligible, and that's not a bad option for you since you're the first one up on the next card.
Yeah. I'm going to do it. We're going to take that event, and I'm just going to stay eligible for forever until we find out that card 11 is actually a coup card.
It's a coup card. So, yeah, and actually what we need to do is, because we're going to stop here, we'll pull out, we'll do the next card and everything, but we'll pull out Medivac. You see that little part underneath the deck part that says momentum cards in play?
Yeah.
So we'll put that one in and that other one just so the next time we start this game, we'll remember that we can't do... all that stuff. Or that I can't. The U.S. can't airstrike and it can't airlift.
Where's it at? There it is. Bombing pause.
Perfect.
There we go. And then, so draw card? Or no, end card play.
End card play.
Which it then took that card and put it into the thing, but that's okay, we can go back.
There we go.
And draw a card.
Alright, so yeah, at least you get another. Yeah, so I knew this was going to be a long round, because our first coup card was so quick, so this medium in-between thing is taking, you know, a while, because we've had the most amount of cards probably possible that you can do that in. Okay, so that's...
That dog is a great card.
Let's see, let's take a look at that before we go. That says... Yeah, remove up to 3 gorillas from a province with a coin space set to act as support, or remove a coin base from a province with 0-2 cubes, oof, U.S. casualties, and set it to active opposition. Ugh. Yeah, losing a base, losing a U.S. base can be really bad.
I know where that's going to happen.
So, no. All right, so this is a great place to stop. We got through a lot more cards. We only got looks like 12 more to go. So that's pretty good for today. I think we burned through a lot there.
Yeah, we did. It's a lot of the finer points of this game have kind of made themselves known for me.
Yeah, that's the thing. You know, people online are always just kind of like, how is the best way to learn to do this? And you really just, it's like a lot of war games, you really just got to jump in and push pieces around. And then eventually you're kind of like, oh, right, you know, like, I need to be thinking of this. Or oh, yeah, that comes out a little bit more. Totally. Especially with the coin games, because like we said in the other cast, you know, there's a lot of moving pieces here, you know, literally, and a lot of moving parts in the rules. So, yeah.
And this game always becomes, the actually playing on a physical board, there's so much to watch. It's such an interesting sort of disconnect to play it on Vassal.
Yeah, it's funny because I've played a lot more Vassal, I think, than like the board presence, and so I love some of the little things that Vassal does. And one time I popped out Andy and Abyss to play a solo game, and I was like moving all the tokens all the time and stuff, and I was like, man, it'd be nicer if there were like a couple other people to help move things around and shift and I wish
I could just push a button.
Yeah, exactly. You get used to that push button thing, you know. Especially this, you know, and that's just part of the game, is like keeping track of all these markers at the top. You know, that's one thing when I've played face to face with people, it's something you really got to stay on top of, because you're like, oh, remember, like you got to move it right now because it costs you this or that, and then during coup rounds, everybody's counting totals and
those little the little white and black pieces come in handy a lot. And
yes.
If anyone ever hits the board, oh
yeah,
my God.
You're like, no. Yeah, it's just toppling of empires. You're like, no. So anyway, well, this is great. I think this will be good for today. And thanks everybody for watching. And just to let you know, I'll probably, since I recorded this one too, it'll get archived and put on YouTube, and we'll put it on BoardGameGeek, or I'll put it on BoardGameGeek, and then get the links out for people that they want to watch it on YouTube, because I forget how long Twitch holds on to videos. I don't know how long they hold
forever.
On to forever. Okay, well, there you go.
Just forever, go to... in the sense of the internet.
Yeah, forever in the internet mind. All right, well, thanks everybody for watching.